So first question, explain the morphology of Indian cities in the backward existing morphological models. Describe the salient characteristics of the morphology of the Indian cities. Morphology of the Indian cities. Urban morphology deals with the physical layout of internal function out structure of the urban area. Here, a physical layout means urban structure or and may be termed as internal geography of which, of the city. Similarly, functional morphology may be interchanged with urban language. Various theories have been advanced by the urban geographers to analyze the morphology of urban centers as follows. Concentric zone theory, just in the concentric zone theory of the urban landscape, language. The concentric zone theory of landscape, urban land use was first proposed in 1923 by E. W. Burgess and urban sociologist in an attempt to explain the pattern of social areas within the city of Chicago. And the model is based on the idea that the growth of the city takes place outward from the central area to form a series of concentric zones. The sector theory was proposed by H. Hoyt in 1939. Sector theory pattern of urban land use is conditioned by the arrangement of land use. It's conditioned by the arrangement of routes radiating out from the city center, which is creating a sectoral pattern of land and rental values, which in turn influence the urban land use pattern. The multiple nuclear theory in 1945, a less rigid model capable of application to variety of urban pattern, was proposed by C.D. Harris and E. Luhlman. It was suggested that land use pattern in most large cities developed around the number of discrete centers and nuclei rather than a single center. Indian towns, on the basis of their morphological characteristics, may be classified under two broad categories: indigenous, these have fully Indian characteristics. Such towns are mainly distributed in the areas of northern plains, desert border land, and Deccan Peninsula, and impact on Southwest Asian culture in the form of narrow winding street. Urban type, these agricultural patterns, cantonment, civil lines, railway colonies, etc., built during the British rule. The general morphology of the Indian cities was initially concentric in nature, and was mostly affected by the physical characteristics on the side of the side. During the British period, with the development of new mohallas, market places, and suburb, it became sectoral. In certain port and capital cities, it is multi-nuclear, depicting the third stage of urban morphology development. The study of general functional structure and urban land use of Indian cities shows that there is an absence of clear separation between residential and other areas. So internal structure of Indian cities. The post-independence period in India saw rapid growth of large centralized towns. This growth was characterized by the following features: growth of residential colonies along radial railroad arteries, to absorption of suburbs by towns, through growth of industry in the intervening spaces, for conversion of old bungalows built during the colonial period into government offices and official residence, planned development of new residential colonies, industrial estates and settler towns. 6. Growth of slums near city centers in areas which are generally low-lying, prone to flooding. These are also used as workplace. And thus, an Indian city is an amalgam of structure of various period and of a variety of land use. Old core of Indian cities, this referred to an old fort, place of worship, or a place around which a town generally grows. In India, these are found to have the following features. There is an intricate maze of lanes and by lanes often ending in dead ends. This traffic in the core is generally one way. The buildings are mostly old ones with particular style or architecture, but generally having a courtyard. Balconies, chhajas, some of these old buildings have been demolished to raise tall buildings. The old core is fragmented of caste and community lines. The old cores generally so lack of lines. Some of the cores have old selectivities. Such cores are characterized by traffic jams and congestion. The old cores also develop restaurant and hotels and to accommodate and waiting businessmen, cantonments and relay colonies. These features also come up during the colonial period and have well planned rectangular street pattern as large open spaces in the form of race course and parade grounds and various services such as schools, colleges, hospitals, post office, etc. are available. In most cases, the cantonments gave a separate identity. Consequence of rail in terms of rail network. So another important stage in process of urbanization in India was the introduction of railway lines. As a consequence of this, the road from say station to the city center gained importance. Shops and hotels came up along this road, around the suburban area, railway station. Housing cluster came up, which were occupied mostly by migrants from outside. In the intervening spaces, industries, residential clusters or slums came up. Most recent developments, the rapid growth of urban road transport has been more extensive than rail lines. These suitable places for suburban growth covered an area of around 50 km from the city center to reduce encouraged dispersal to suburbs by providing basic facilities. Indian cities and towns can be broadly classified as follows: administrative towns and cities. Towns supporting administrative headquarters of higher order, such as Chandigarh, New Delhi, Bhopal, Shillong, etc. Industrial towns, industries constitute prime motive force of these cities, such as Mumbai, Salem, Coimbatore, Modinagar, Jamshedpur, Hooghly, Bhilai, etc. Transport tourism, they may be ports primarily engaged to export in export and import, such as Kandla, Kochi, Kajikod, Mughalsarai, Itar, Rasi, etc. Commercial towns and cities specializing in trade and commerce are kept in this, like Kolkata and Saharanpur, mining towns, Raniganj, Jharia, Digboi, and Singrauli, etc. Entertainment towns, Ambala, Jalandhar, Mau, Bhavina, Meerut, education town, Roorkee, Varanasi, Aligarh, Pilani. And religious and cultural towns, Varanasi, Mathura, Madurai, Tripura, Tirupati, tourist towns, Nainital, Mussoorie, Simla, Pachmari, Mount Abu. Even specialized cities as they grow onto metropolis become intermittent multinationals wherein industry, business, administration, transport, etc. Within each medium or large city, there are specific areas specializing in certain functions or activities like business, industrial, and administrative, institutional, and transport, residential, etc. Business area is often the core and the center of the city. So, thank you.